So students, in this video, now before solving a few numericals, so now let us finalize the topic. Okay, let us now finalize this topic. We have discussed about the working stress method, we discussed about the ultimate load method, and we discussed about the limited state method also, right? But a lot of students, they still get confused between the working stress method and the limited state method, okay? So now let us see the difference between the limited state method and the working stress method. Let us make a comparison, and after that we'll be solving some numericals. So first of all, the working stress method, it's a deterministic approach. Why deterministic approach? Because we actually know the factor of safety, right? How much is the factor of safety? It is 3 for bending and 4 for compression, right? For concrete. Now, in the working stress method, we are actually dealing with the factor of safety. I have already told you, right? Factor of safety. And what is factor of safety? The permissible stress divided by the stress acting on that particular structure, right? Okay. And how much is the permissible stress? The characteristic stress divided by the factor of safety, right? Now, it is an elastic behavior of concrete, because I told you that this is a stress strain curve for concrete. Actually, it is like this. But what we imagine it to be a straight line like this in the working stress method. And we are dealing up to this location only. We are not utilizing this thing. Clear? Now, that is a linear behavior actually. Okay, the next thing is working or service loads. Now, what are the working or service loads? I have already explained. I gave an example of an office building, right? So, everything has been explained. It is less economical, because if you design any structure with the, you can say, the working stress method, you have thick walls, thick columns, thick beams, right? So, it is not economical, because we are actually not utilizing the full strength of that particular structure. Clear? Now, coming to the limited state method, it is a probabilistic approach. I told you that a lot of methods of statics and probability are used to determine the partial factor of safeties, right? But it is more accurate as compared to the working stress method. Clear? Now, partial factors of safety are taken into consideration, and you apply partial factor of safety two times. First of all, with the load, you multiply the working load with the partial factor of safety to get the ultimate load. And when you get the strength for that particular load, you divide it again with the partial factor of safety. It means that you are providing two-way authentication. You can say two-way factor of safety, actually, two times. Clear? Now, next thing, it is plastic behavior. Already explained to you, we are actually dealing with this portion also, because we are dealing with the ultimate loads, not the working loads or service loads. Clear? Non-linear behavior. So here, we take into consideration non-linear behavior. So in the working stress method, the linear behavior was considered, and here non-linear behavior is also considered. Factored loads, right? Here we just had the working loads, but here the working loads or service loads into a partial factor of safety, which gives you factored loads or the ultimate loads, right? So it is more economical. So this is the comparison between LSM and WSM. So I hope that now the topic of LSM and WSM is very much clear to you. Now in next video, I will be solving a few numericals which I told in the previous video. But now let us solve a few numericals on the basic derivations of LSM, which can be asked in subsequent gate examinations. Okay, so let's meet at the next video and clear our concepts more stronger. Right, let's make our concepts more stronger on this topic, the LSM and WSM. So let's meet at the next video.